When we look at this globe of our world, you can probably see how Earth got the nickname the Blue Planet. All that blue? It represents the water on our planet. In fact, over 70% of the Earth's surface is covered in water. It's what makes our planet so special. The presence of all that water is why Earth is able to support life in the first place. Not all water plays the same role in supporting life, though. Today, we're going to learn about the small fraction of water that most living things depend on to survive. Freshwater. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to identify where freshwater can be found on Earth, explain where freshwater comes from, and explain the importance of freshwater to life on Earth. So, have your guided notes ready, and let's get started! About 71% of Earth's surface is covered in water. That sounds like a lot, doesn't it? Well, let's break it down. If we gathered all that water together, over 97% would be salt water. That's water with a high amount of salt in it and is most often found in Earth's seas and oceans. If we look at what's left, that's not very much. Out of all the water on Earth, less than 3% is freshwater. Freshwater is naturally occurring liquid or frozen water that doesn't contain salt. Surprisingly, we can't even use most of that 3% because it's either frozen in glaciers and ice caps or too far under the Earth's surface. Out of all the water on Earth, only about 0.5% is usable fresh water. You heard that right, that's half of 1%. Even though that may not sound like a lot, fortunately, that half a percent represents about 30 quadrillion gallons of fresh water. That's enough water to cover the entire continental United States in 50 feet of water. Since we know most of the water on our planet is oceanic salt water, and most of our freshwater sources are inaccessible, let's think about the freshwater we do have access to. Where is it all? We're going to need to zoom in on our map to find it. These thin blue lines represent rivers and streams, while these wider shapes represent lakes, ponds, and wetlands. These bodies of water are usually sources of freshwater. There's even fresh water underground. This is called groundwater, and it's water that has seeped below the Earth's surface. Groundwater often collects in aquifers. These are absorbent layers of rock and sediment, where water can collect and flow between tiny cracks and crevices. This brings us to our next question. Let's take a moment to pause and think. Where does all this fresh water come from? How does it get to our rivers, lakes, and aquifers? Pause here and share your thoughts in your guided notes. If you thought it had something to do with the water cycle, you're right! Remember, the water cycle is the process that keeps water constantly moving through the spheres of the Earth. Fortunately, our source of fresh water is always being replenished thanks to precipitation like rain and snow. You might be surprised to learn that thanks to the water cycle, we get a lot of our fresh water from saltwater sources. After all, saltwater represents most of the water on our planet. When saltwater evaporates from the ocean's surface, the salt stays behind. Then, the water vapor condenses and fresh water precipitation falls back to Earth, refilling our rivers, lakes, and streams. Thanks to infiltration and percolation, the water soaks into the ground and helps refill groundwater sources and aquifers, too. The presence of fresh water on Earth is closely connected to the water cycle, but that also means our access to fresh water can change. For example, a drought happens when an area gets less than its usual amount of precipitation. We depend on predicted weather patterns and regular precipitation in order to replenish sources and avoid water shortages. Freshwater is essential for all life on Earth, including mammals, birds, fish, reptiles, amphibians, insects, plants, and even fungi. Even though salt water makes up most of the water on our planet, most living things, including humans, can't use it as a source of hydration because they can't process the salt out quickly enough. Drinking salt water just makes most living things thirstier. In addition to being needed by all living things, freshwater also connects many processes in Earth's spheres. Remember, moving freshwater can cause erosion and deposition by moving and building up new layers of rock and sediment. The presence of freshwater even helps control the Earth's temperature. The frozen ice caps help reflect heat off of the Earth's surface and help maintain a more stable climate, meaning less droughts and extreme storms. Small bodies of freshwater regulate the local temperature too. These processes are interconnected, and each plays an important role in shaping our planet and our everyday lives. Nearly everything in our lives uses freshwater in some way. Fortunately, the water cycle helps replenish our sources. It's important to use our water wisely to ensure there's enough for everyone and everything that needs it, while we wait for natural sources to refill. The whole process takes time. Some small steps we can make today for a more sustainable future could include turning off the faucet, fixing leaks, and taking shorter showers. You might be thinking, I'm just one person, can I really make a difference? Well, if just one person turns off their faucet while they brush their teeth, they can save nearly 3,000 gallons of water a year. And you won't be alone in trying to make these changes either. Farmers are developing crops that require less water. Companies are working to reduce the amount of water used in the manufacturing process. One person can make a difference because they inspire others to make a difference too. So, let's go over what we learned today. You now know that fresh water can be found in rivers, lakes, streams, wetlands, glaciers, and underground reservoirs. Most of our fresh water is inaccessible because it is frozen or too deep beneath the Earth's surface. Freshwater and saltwater are connected by the water cycle, which replenishes the freshwater on Earth through precipitation. And lastly, it is important to conserve fresh water because all living things on Earth depend on it to survive. Be sure to check out the games and extension activities that go with this lesson. And remember, in Earth science as in life, you rock! See you next time! Hey, hey.